often you hear about Broward's top cop getting the cuffs out and taking a suspect into custody, but that's exactly what Sheriff Gregory Tony did with a suspected shoplifter, and you saw it exclusively first on 10. Our Michael Putney is live with more of that interview. Michael.
Nicole, Broward Sheriff Gregory Tony is the leader of a huge agency. More than 5,000 people work for him, a big administrative job, but at heart, he is just a cop, and he acted like one when he saw a shoplifter trying to rip off this 7-Eleven. Surveillance video sets the scene. The alleged shoplifter, seen here carrying a green bag, picks out about $40 worth of items, then scurries out of the store without paying. The sheriff just happened to be driving by.
As we're driving by, I saw a young man running top speed across the on Broward Boulevard. Further looked, and I noticed that there was an employee chasing me, a 7-Eleven employee chasing behind a young man. So I told my security staff to pull up, and foot pursuit began.
This is where the sheriff finally caught up with the suspect, Southwest 4th Avenue. It is quite a sprint from the 7-Eleven. The sheriff says he wasn't winded.
I think he was surprised in general that somebody was behind him that he didn't know was chasing him. Once I caught up to him and I took him down, and we place him in handcuffs and start talking to him, I can see the register like, wait a minute, I've seen this guy before. And then we joked a little bit. I said, hey, you just made part of history. I'm probably the first sheriff to be involved in a foot pursuit in probably decades.
He took a lot of stuff.
No one was happier about it than the 7-Eleven manager.
When I was get too close, the sheriff took over. So the sheriff took over and handcuffed him and then solved the problem.
Right. Pretty cool for the sheriff to do it himself.
Of course. It was the coolest thing, you know.
It was the coolest thing. Sheriff Tony has had a few rocky moments in his 5 months in office when deputies made rough arrests of some young black men. Today, or Monday, I should say, he made the arrest of a young black man. It was picture perfect, setting a good example. We're live in Fort Lauderdale. Michael Putney, Local 10 News.